your screen.
News 12, voted best weather coverage by the Georgia Association of Broadcasters. From the station that's on your side, this is News 12, First at 5.
We are live from Los Angeles, the Dawgs trying to become the first team to win back-to-back national championships since the college football playoff began.
And meanwhile, TCU is trying to win their first national championship since 1938.
Okay, Dawgs, we know how the Horned Frogs feel. It had been a long time for us, too. Not that long, granted, but decades when we won it last year, and we want to win it again this year.
And our Dan Booth and Alyssa Lyons join us now live from L.A. at the game day experience. We see the fans. How is the energy out there? You guys look like you're about to race out there.
Yeah, you do.
Okay, so this has been a lot of fun so far today. I think Alyssa and I could both agree on that. We are in the L.A. Convention Center as a part of Playoff Fan Central. There are so many games that we had the opportunity to play. Alyssa beat me in when we were kicking before to get the first game in the series, and then I came back and won round two when we were throwing in some tires for a little competition. But we're going to have to put our legs to the work for this.
Oh my gosh, yeah, that one we're just going to I just don't think the last one should really count because I won in the practice round. Practice ain't perfect, but we're just not going to talk anymore about that fumble on live television. Hopefully this one's a little bit better. I don't really have, running shoes on. You have Reeboks. I feel like I should get, a little head start here, Dan.
You know what? I'm also wearing slacks, so I'm going to talk shop after that.
All right, whatever. Right. Count us
ready?
Out. Let's go.
Let's do this.
You ready?
All right.
Up on down. 3, 2, 1, go! Coast!
Man, that was, I feel like a little winded.
All right, so, I'm pretty sure I got that.
How many seconds?
Yeah, I'm curious, how long was that?
Oh, God, that blew away from the book. That was really bad.
All right.
Oh, God, my phone fell out of my pants. that was a lot of fun. you need to catch my breath. But,
yeah.
I mean, we've been here, we keep, competing, I think, we're having more fun than the kids that are here.
Probably. I think I have the same assumption.
Well,
in terms of that, if you want to see any of our competitions throughout the day or any digital content that is exclusive to all of our apps, streaming services, websites, anything like that, it'll be there on all of that. It is going to be amazing. We're going to continue to have live shots and be with you throughout the night. But until then, we're going to re-catch our breath. And let the youngsters do their thing.
I mean, they're running faster than Dan and Alyssa right now.
Yeah.
I want to see their time. Oh, okay. You guys were a little bit faster, to be fair.
Yeah, but if you talk to them, I bet they could talk without
being so
winded.
So out of
to be fair, to be fair, guys, I would have tripped and fallen, or I would be even more out of breath than y'all are.
Alyssa had a false start, too, so that's what also happened.
Dan took that out. Look at that.
I did, which I'm going to fix in a second. However,
what's that score?
I also
did
so
5-8.
I was able to get the comebackers I was happy about.
Sweat.
That was really fast.
All right, guys, we'll check back in with you, let you catch your breath. Thanks for the live updates out there in L.A.
Yeah, taking a victory lap. Way to go.
That's all you need. Taking a live look outside at Riley, a utility worker, was sent to the hospital after a minor accident this morning in Columbia County. The sheriff's office says the employee was working on utility lines on Old Bel Air Lane. They say that the box truck came through and pulled the lines down at around 9:15 this morning. We're told the worker was conscious at the scene. The road opened back up after a couple of hours.
A Greenbrier High School student facing criminal charges tonight after bringing a knife to school. Just 2 hours ago, parents were sent a notification about this incident. After the investigation, administrators say they found the knife and removed the student from campus. There was no threat made to students or staff. As a reminder, officials are asking parents, please talk to your children about the consequences of bringing weapons to school. Today marks 2 years since the attack on the U.S. Capitol. This morning, a bipartisan group of lawmakers held a 140-second moment of silence. That is 1 second for every officer seriously hurt in the attack. On January 6, 2021, 2021, a mob stormed the Capitol trying to block Congress from certifying the results of the 2020 presidential election. Five officers died as a result of the violence that day. Family of the fallen officers were at today's ceremony.
And today's January 6th remembrances are happening as the U.S. House remains locked in a heated debate. It's the fourth day of voting for the new Speaker of the House. Today, Republican leader Kevin McCarthy picked up 14 new votes, but it still falls short of what he needs to win the post. However, there are signs a resolution could be in the works. The 14 new votes Representative McCarthy picked up today were from a group of 20 far-right Republicans who had been voting for someone else. It's the first time there has been any momentum in the drawn-out vote here. Some moderate Republicans are concerned it's being pushed forward with backroom deals.
These things went too far and completely changed the way Congress runs, then that might be a bridge too far.
And this is the longest contest for Speaker of the House in more than 160 years.
More good news for Buffalo Bills safety Damar Hamlin. Today the team says Hamlin is breathing on his own. The 24-year-old was able to talk to his families and teammates, and head coach Sean McDermott said Hamlin FaceTimed them in the team meeting. And then when players saw them, they all stood up and clapped. As you can imagine, an emotional moment. Coach Sean also said Damar took a moment to flex.
Good news there for Damar Hamlin.
Incredible.
His family and teammates.
Recovery.
Great recovery to see that there. And Georgia's new legislative session got underway this week. A hot topic issue some lawmakers are focusing on is making sports gambling legal.
Polls say Georgia voters overwhelmingly support it, and the incoming lieutenant governor is even backing the bill. But as Abby Kosoris reports, there is a holdup.
Right now, sports betting in Georgia is only available through offshore websites. The Sports Betting Alliance says that is unsafe. It would like to see a way for sports betting to be legalized so that it could benefit state and local governments. Last year, Representative Ron Stevens led a push to legalize sports betting.
And you work on it, eventually it kind of falls into place.
The bill failed. But this year, the Republican from Savannah has hope.
Every time we bring it up, there's less opposition.
Incoming Lieutenant Governor Burt Jones has expressed his support. Lawmakers have differed on what should be done with the revenue. Stephen wants the money to fund the Hope Scholarship that gives money to help Georgia students start and finish college.
3.6 million families that have been touched with Pre-K and Hope, so it's become this sacred cow.
Stephen says gaming legislation will require two bills before Georgia voters would get the final say. One bill would require a constitutional amendment, and the second would lay out exactly how the revenue will be spent.
We had some folks that testified on our extreme right that said this is the wrong thing to do, and I had to point out very quickly, you understand that every dime from Hope comes from gaming.
Within the last year, seven states have either expanded or legalized sports betting. In Atlanta, I'm Abby Kosoris.
And some big money there in the sports gambling market for sure.
Yeah, and it's been controversial, but again, polls are showing that Georgia voters overwhelmingly support it. We've got the incoming lieutenant governor supporting it, so it'll be interesting to see what happens coming up.
Yeah, we'll keep you updated on all of that.
All right, take a look at this. America is split on who will take Monday's college football championship game. To make this map, Bet Online tracked more than 110,000 tweets using the hashtags Go Dogs and Go Frogs. In the end, TCU is the people's national champion as they own support from six more states than UGA, outpacing the Dogs there 28-22. I get it. We won last year. If I were not a Georgia fan, I would be going for TCU.
Listen,
too.
I didn't wear my purple tie on purpose today because I didn't want to make anyone mad.
I would not. You would not have made me mad. You went to Carolina. That's fine. But I'm just going to point out that I root for you every time that you don't play Georgia. So let's just put that on the table there.
I don't care.
Just saying.
I appreciate your support.
You're welcome.
Billions of dollars will be spent in South Carolina next year, and now the head of the state is calling to raise pay for teachers. We explain how and why, coming up after the break. Riley? Well, we got lots of sunshine in the forecast for the first half of the weekend. A few more clouds by Sunday, and we are tracking a chance for rain by Sunday night. Update there just after the break.
how former students are remembering the passing of their favorite teacher. That's all new, coming up all new on News 12 at 6 o'clock.
Time in.
Once again, some rain Sunday night, but looking mostly dry as we head into the first part of next week. More rain, though, as we head into next Friday.
Thanks, Riley. Governor Henry McMaster is calling for South Carolina to give every public school teacher a bonus and a raise in to raise teachers' salaries starting again next year.
It is all part of his 2023 executive budget, his recommendations to the General Assembly for how to spend billions of dollars. State House reporter Mary Green joins us from Columbia to break all of this down.
And Mary, the state recently got...
Yes, Will, Meredith, the state recently got that good news from budget forecasters who anticipate South Carolina will have an additional $3.8 billion to spend this year. That's coming from surplus revenue.
Here are some of the highlights from the governor's 2023 executive budget. He wants to put $500 million into the state's rainy day fund. A new state law calls for the top state income tax rate to drop from 6.5%, where it is now, to 6% over the next 5 years. McMaster is calling for the state to make those cuts sooner, if revenues allow. The governor also wants to put $850 million to speed up the state's road and bridge improvement plan, which includes highway widenings. And next year, McMaster is asking to increase the statewide starting salary for teachers from $40,000 up to $42,500. And give every public school teacher a one-time $2,500 bonus.
Our future is bright. There's some other places that are still struggling, but not us. We have lifted off, and we are on the move. And we just need to be sure that we have the strength in our educational system and our infrastructure to handle what's coming our way.
And Governor McMaster is also recommending allocating $78 million to state agencies to help them out with employee recruitment and retention, and so that they can offer new hires a one-time $2,500 sign-on bonus. Now, what McMaster is not recommending is across-the-board raises for all state employees, saying that a study recently found that some state agencies are already offering salaries that are competitive with the private sector. Reporting live from South Carolina State House, Mary Green on your side.
Thanks, Mary. Lawmakers get to work writing the budget shortly after their legislative session begins next Tuesday.
And of course, we'll be following that. We're back in a bit. On your side means more now than ever before. It means keeping you informed, from COVID to community events and everything else in between. You can count on us to shine a light on what's important to our community. Taking a live look inside the Georgia Aquarium, this is the Ocean Voyager Cam. The Georgia Aquarium's goal is to continue sea life preservation efforts, but now their mission is picking up steam thanks to social media. Some pretty cool stuff there.
You love to see all the little fishes going around. Now they're right behind us.
I know.
We were talking about putting a real fish tank right here behind
us. Wouldn't that be fun?
Yeah, terrible idea.
I know. Who would clean it?
I think Riley over there just raised his hand.
But when you think of viral videos, you might think about influencers or celebrities and people maybe in front of the camera.
But the Georgia Aquarium's account is getting millions of views and likes, all to educate people on the animals they can help protect. Sawyer Bussey has our story.
They'll make you laugh, so rockin', put you in awe, make you dream. The Georgia Aquarium TikTok page is full of videos meant to introduce you to animals you might have written off, to animals you might never thought you'd see in person.
For us, it's really about getting people to care about animals and getting people to care about Georgia Aquarium and what we do.
The TikTok page has 1.5 million followers, 28.4 million likes.
Georgia Aquarium started their TikTok page in March of 2020. The highest viewing video we've ever had is just under 40 million.
The Georgia Aquarium is a nonprofit. They work towards preservation of aquatic wildlife worldwide. That work can start here in their building, but sometimes it starts here on your phone.
It's really wonderful for people to be able to see our animals up close on their phones and form a connection with them, because when you get people to care about animals, then they care about what's happening to them and they care about what's happening to our planet.
Sawyer Bussy.
I'm sorry, turn around. Hi, buddy.
Just sitting there watching her, right there in the background.
A photobomb.
That's awesome.
One of the best kinds,
I
guess.
One of the best photobombs, but 1.5 million followers for them. 28.4, I think it was, likes for them. So get some good attention down there in Atlanta.
Well, they're about to have a new TikTok follower, because I wasn't following them, but now I'm going to. I did not know. I followed them on Instagram. I didn't know they had a TikTok account.
Yeah, pretty cool stuff. If you have not gone to the Georgia Aquarium, definitely plan to make a trip up there. It is worth every penny. Hey, early tomorrow morning, we can actually see a pretty good view of the International Space Station. More on this in that weekend outlook just after break.
You're at childrenscancer.org.
You enjoy the WRDW app on your phone, but did you know you can also stream it on your TV? Even if you cut the cord, you don't have to lose your local news.
Wait, what?
Or your first alert weather with the free WRDW streaming app.
Well, that's good news.
And it's easy to do. Just type in or search WRDW, and you've got your local news, first alert weather, sports, and more. The WRDW News app on your Roku, Amazon Fire, or Apple TV Store.
How are we going to